Good morning. I'm Dr. Polack. Today I'm going to talk about vaping. What do you do if you find your teenager or preteen vaping? How do you know that they are vaping if you don't see them but you suspect it, and what to do once they do start to vape? So my name is Dr. Polack. I am a pediatrician. I've been practicing pediatrics since 1996 in Union City in Bayonne, New Jersey. Vaping is the new epidemic. It was that way before this COVID pandemic began, and it is going to continue to be that way. Let's be prepared for when our children return to school. And as parents and as educators, let's know what to do. Here are the bottom line numbers here. Many children in their teen and preteen years are vaping. They're using vape pens. And one Juul pod, one of those little juice pods that they call them, has the equivalent amount of nicotine as one pack of cigarettes. Some of these teenagers that I've seen are smoking 1 to 3 of those Juul pods per day. So they're smoking the equivalent nicotine of 1 to 3 packs per day, and that will definitely affect their health. How will it affect their health? First of all, young brains that are still developing are much easier to become addicted. So they become addicted much faster than adults do. Number two, the nicotine can cause neurotoxicity or nerve damage in the developing brain, and that can be a permanent change in their brain. And number three, the chemicals that they put in the flavoring of these e-juices can also cause damage to the lungs. So I have had patients admitted to the ICU because of EVOLI, which is e-cigarette and vaping associated lung injury. They needed to be in the ICU, and it was, pretty serious condition. And as you've heard in the news, some teenagers have actually died due to EVOLI. So let's get on board with how to prevent vaping in our children and in our community. So I've been asked before by teenagers, is it better to vape or to smoke, doctor? And the answer is neither. They're both nicotine. They're both addicting. They're both going to harm your brain and your lungs. Don't do it. But there's a lot of peer pressure out there. And I want to let parents know that to be on the lookout for smoking either cigarettes or vape. Please, parents, know that once a person starts to vape, especially a teenager, they're 4 times as likely to continue to go on to smoke cigarettes, actual cigarettes. So let's take care of that. So how do you know if your child is vaping? You got to listen really carefully to how they're speaking to their friends. There's a lot of language around vaping. So they can call it vaping or juuling. They can call it dripping juice. They can call it cloud chasing. All of those terms mean that they're smoking some kind of an electronic cigarette. The cigarettes themselves, the electronic cigarettes, can be called pods, juuls, e-cigarettes, or vape pens. There's probably a million other names out there that I don't know about, but this is what I've been learning from the kids that I'm seeing, and also from, the literature out there. Parents, please be aware that there's something now called vapeware. What is vapeware? That is clothing that helps you to hide your vape pen. So, for example, I have seen a hoodie that you can hide your vape pen into, and you can smoke it through the string of your hoodie. Holy cow, that is really deceptive. So you got to really have eyes open out there to make sure that your teenagers are not buying vapeware or wearing vapeware. So that's how you can figure it out. Now, what to do if you find out that your child is vaping? First of all, talk to them in an age-appropriate manner. If you have a preteen between 12 and 15 and you think they're not the most mature person yet, talk to them like this. Ask, do your friends sometimes vape? Have you seen people around the school vaping or smoking electronic cigarettes? And if they say yes, you can go into asking them, what do you think about it? Tell me your thoughts. They may think it's gross, I'm going to stay away from it, which is great. Or they may say, I'm curious, I might try it one time, in which case you should really let them know how addicting it is and how it can affect their brains. And you should, as a parent, also let them know, hey, I expect you to never try this product. This is not something that is okay to experiment with because it is very addicting. Now, in the teenagers, you know, 15 and up, especially if you think they're mature enough to have this discussion, please have it. The discussion should be had with a grown-up. And we do have this kind of discussion at every well visit with a teenager in our office. We have it with the teenager alone, though, without the parent in the room, so we can get as much honesty as possible. So you talk to your teenager and you ask them what their friends are doing, what's happening out there in school or and outside of school, and you find out if they're vaping. If you do either find out by them telling you or you find some kind of paraphernalia around, please understand that this is an addiction. So if your child's been doing it for a day or two, it's possible that you say, stop doing this, or I'm going to take away this big electronic or this big thing, and they stop. But if they have been juuling or smoking these nicotine cigarettes for months, I want you to know that it's now an addiction. Your threatening them may not do the trick. In that case, you must seek medical attention. Please, we would like to help them get rid of this terrible habit so that they don't have it for the rest of their lives. How would we do that? We would do an evaluation of how bad the situation is. Are they addicted? And then we would help you to find resources as to how they can get off of this kind of an addiction, which is truly an addiction. So my name is Dr. Noha Polack. I want you to know that vaping is out there. It's all over the place. It is our job as educators, physicians, and parents to not normalize vaping at all in our community. It is best not to have your children and teens around a lot of people who are vaping. I'm hoping that we can all be role models and not smoke or vape, and that we understand that this is an addiction, and it's our job to help these teenagers, number one, never use it, and if they do use it, to get off of vaping. So at Progressive Pediatrics, we take care of and address all of these issues. We're open 7 days a week in Union City and 5 days a week in Bayonne. We'll be happy to help you take care of your preteen and teen. Call us anytime for an appointment and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.